The rate at which corporations resort to declaring bankruptcy is a vital sign of economic performance. S&P Global's latest report reveals a startling trend. In the initial 8 months, spanning from January to August this year, corporate bankruptcies have surged past the figures of the previous 2 years. This unsettling rise is occurring against a backdrop of persistently high interest rates and a labor market stretched thin. The stark reality becomes even more evident as we examine the data. In the year 2023 alone, the firm documented an astounding 459 bankruptcy filings, a figure that surpasses the entire annual counts of both 2021 and 2022 combined. Furthermore, the year-to-date statistic stands higher than the corresponding totals for all but two of the past 13 years. Take a look at this chart. The data shown is very alarming. The dark blue segment represents the 459 bankruptcies as of August, and it already outpaces not only the previous 2 years, but also every other year since 2011. According to a recent report, a staggering 700 United States banks are in an uncertain situation, surpassing the official guidance on their allowable exposure to commercial real estate loans, also known as corporate real estate loans. The gut-wrenching truth is that small banks in the United States hold over 70% of these loans, totaling a staggering $2 trillion. If it wasn't alarming enough, office building vacancies have reached a historic high, and the trend of corporations defaulting is surging. You can be certain that this foreboding trend is poised to hike even higher in 2024. The potential effect on these small banks is unclear, creating doubts about their future stability. The majority of bankruptcies plagues three pivotal sectors: consumer discretionary, industrials, and healthcare. In times of consumer conflict, the first to suffer are consumer discretionary items as people shift their attention from wants to needs. This distressing trend is most pronounced in three American states: Texas, New York, and California. This mirrors the dark days of the Great Recession in 2008. This historical indicator always signals financial trouble, often coming before big stock market crashes. Whether a disaster is about to happen is a different conversation, but history has often shown this dangerous connection. Companies are grappling with overwhelming debt burdens, signaling the highest corporate defaults since 2009. The procession of failing firms is set to rise if the Federal Reserve chooses to enact another rate hike this year. S&P Global predicts that the United States will be trailing the 12-month corporate default rate, soaring to a daunting 4.5% by June of 2024. Just to put things in perspective, as of this past July, that rate stood at a mere 3.5%, a nearly 30% surge in just a single year. But here's the crux of the matter. American outfits are standing on the precipice of a colossal wave of maturing debt in the near future. Brace yourselves for this staggering revelation. A mind-boggling $790 billion is set to mature in 2024, followed by a jaw-dropping $1.07 trillion due the very next year in 2025. Now here's the kicker. When the Federal Reserve steps up with its updates and soothing promises of soft lending, they conveniently omit this impending financial storm. We're on the brink of 2024, and the Fed is gazing at the same harrowing figures I've just laid out for you. It's crucial to recognize that we're not talking about small, obscure firms going belly up. We're talking about corporate titans. Take the recent filing by the Yellow Corporation, for instance. This massive corporation filed for bankruptcy in August, a move that impacted tens of thousands of employees. Those are jobs lost. In the business world where corporations earn money, there's a growing problem. When we examine how people are managing their credit cards, it's clear that more of them are failing to make timely payments. And a similar trend is observed in car loans, where more people are struggling to repay them. Firms which thrive on revenue from their customers find themselves at the epicenter of this monetary unrest. Large corporations deal with a lot of things they're not sure about, and many difficult challenges. Even though it takes some time for the complete results of raising interest rates to happen in the economy, we can already notice clear signs. This is a matter that warrants the attention of the Federal Reserve, yet it remains conspicuously absent from their discourse. Treasury Secretary Yellen recently expressed optimism about lenient lending practices, but the thriving wave of bankruptcies is not confined to the United States. Europe grapples with an identical crisis, compounded by a more fragile economic backdrop. S&P Global's report presents a troubling forecast. Default rates are assured to climb as companies grapple with heightened borrowing costs and imminent debt maturities. By June 2024, the United States is anticipated to witness a 4.5% corporate default rate, a sharp ascent from July's 3.5%. Across the Atlantic, Europe's default rate is expected to reach 3.75% by June 2024, up from 3.1% in July of the same year. Mohamed Al-Aryan, chief economic advisor at Alliance and a respected Bloomberg opinion columnist, voices grave concerns. He finds himself deeply troubled by the specter of soaring interest rates in the coming year and the high decline in corporate real estate values. Corporate bankruptcies are sounding a clarion call, an alert that echoes through every tier of our social structure. The reverberations will inevitably reach employment levels and corporate profits. These corporations are thinking about reducing the money they give to shareholders and the raises they give to employees to deal with the upcoming storm. Commercial real estate, as previously explored, also faces issues. Property values are set to plummet as the institutions buckle under this strain, leading in an era of rising vacancy rates. As valuations plummet, any investments attached to these assets will bear witness to sharp declines in value. This phenomenon of companies facing financial turmoil and ultimately filing for bankruptcy is not new. Throughout the annals of economic history, we find instances of corporate giants stumbling, often with far-reaching consequences. The earliest recorded corporate bankruptcy dates back to the Dutch tulip mania of the 17th century. During this speculative storm, the price of tulip bulbs soared to astronomical levels before crashing, leaving many investors bankrupt. Although it might look like a one-time thing caused by overly excited behavior, it actually set the stage for us to understand the risky bubbles that would happen in the centuries ahead. Fast forward to the 19th century, and we encounter the famous Panic of 1837 in the United States. This financial crisis, triggered by a speculative bubble in the trading of land and cotton, led to a wave of economic failures. Many banks, businesses, and individuals faced fiscal ruin, and the country experienced a severe fiscal downturn. The 20th century witnessed its share of corporate collapses as well. The Great Depression of the 1930s saw a multitude of businesses shutter their doors due to plummeting demand and a banking system in turmoil. Iconic companies, once seen as invincible, crumbled under the weight of financial despair. Then came the dot-com bubble of the late 1990s and early 2000s. The surge in internet-related investments created an outburst that seemed boundless. The corporations with little to no revenue were valued in the billions, and investors poured money into anything with a dot-com attached to it. When the bubble burst, a multitude of startups went bankrupt, and trillions of dollars in market value evaporated. These liquidations are like warning signs on the economic highway, signaling trouble ahead. When corporations, big or small, find themselves sinking in debt, it's not just their shareholders who suffer. The effects ripple across the entire ecosystem. One immediate consequence is job loss. As businesses go bankrupt, they often need to lay off employees to cut costs. This leads to widespread unemployment and monetary hardship for individuals and their families. The recent surge is a grim reminder of how quickly fiscal stability can unravel. It also impacts suppliers and partners. When a major corporation goes down, it leaves a trail of unpaid bills, affecting the institutions that relied on its business. This domino effect weakens supply chains and disrupts industries. Government finances will take a hit as well. When bankruptcy occurs, the affected firms leave behind unpaid taxes and unfulfilled government contracts. This will strain public resources and necessitate budget adjustments. Financial markets are not immune to the shockwaves either. Investors face significant losses. Bondholders in particular find themselves holding worthless securities. The fear leads to stock market volatility, and a sharp downturn wipes out any substantial wealth. Insolvency is not just an economic footnote, it has far-reaching implications for the broader economy. Here's a closer look at its ripple effects. When a corporation defaults, it often results in layoffs and job losses. Employees, who had counted on their jobs for stability, find themselves suddenly unemployed. This not only impacts individual livelihoods, but also adds to the burden of unemployment benefits and social safety nets, which will strain government resources. It disrupts supply chains, affecting suppliers and customers alike. If a major corporation that serves as a linchpin in a supply network goes under, it leads to a domino effect, causing smaller companies in the supply chain to suffer. This disruption has far-reaching consequences on various industries. It shakes the confidence in capital markets. Lenders and investors become cautious, leading to tighter credit conditions. As it rises, creditors become more stringent in their lending practices, making it harder for both individuals and corporations to access credit, and it results in reduced consumer spending. Consumers become wary of making purchases from businesses that are financially unstable. This decline in spending has a cascading effect on other businesses, especially those in the retail sector. Investors take a hit when companies in which they hold stakes default. The value of their investments will plummet, affecting their economic well-being and future plans. Bankruptcies will significantly affect the real estate market. Vacancy rates in commercial properties would rise as businesses close shop, impacting property owners and landlords who rely on rental income. As we navigate this intricate terrain, one thing becomes abundantly clear. They are not isolated events, but rather integral components of the economic cycle. While they signal challenges, they also create opportunities for rebirth and innovation. In the face of bankruptcies, governments often intervene to stabilize the economy. Measures such as stimulus packages, job retraining programs, and monetary assistance to affected industries aim to mitigate the fallout. Central banks will have to adjust interest rates to encourage lending and investment. They serve as cautionary tales. They remind us of the importance of prudent capital management, risk assessment, and the need for diversified investment portfolios. They highlight the ever-present need for due diligence and vigilance in the world of finance. To wrap things up, corporate bankruptcies, though troubling, aren't uncommon, but rather something we regularly face in our economy. They remind us that financial stability is a fragile thing, and even the biggest companies will stumble into money troubles. In our ever-changing world, being able to adjust and stand firm when they hit is essential. As we look ahead, let's stay alert, learn from the past, and get ready for the economic challenges that are coming our way. That's it for today. If you like the content we do here on this channel, consider subscribing, and we'll see you in the next one.